Okay. So this is an old lady in new clothes. Lady Madonna, children at your feet, one day on your manners to make ends meet. Who finds the money when you pay the rent? Did you know that money was heaven sent? Friday night arrived without a suitcase, Sunday morning creeping like a nun. Monday's child has learned to tie his bootlace. Needed mending. See how they run. Oh, now Lady Madonna, lying on the bed, listen to playing in your pretty little head. Listening to the music playing in your pretty little head. In your pretty little head. Ooh, oh yeah. In your pretty little head. Mm-hmm. Well, you listen to the music playing in your pretty little head. This is a new song, and when I was about to write this, what happened was I was abroad and I asked for a cup of tea. Now, if you're in England, you say a cup of tea and they know what you mean. But if you're abroad, they say, what kind of tea? But you have to say English breakfast tea and then you'll get a cup of tea. And I've got quite a few friends, and I'm thinking of a particular sort of older lady who's posh. And I noticed that when she talked, she just had other phrases. So whereas I might say, would you like a cup of tea? She'd say, would you care to take a cup of tea? So I started noticing these little phrases. Once I got into this world of sort of eccentric old English ladies, I suddenly remembered, I read a lot of Charles Dickens, I suddenly remembered this word, peradventure. So I wrote it in the song, and I thought, I can get away with this. This will be cool. And I looked it up in the dictionary just to be sure. And sure enough, it means perhaps. It means maybe. Oh, peradventure, I'm amazed. So you'll find that snuck in here. the word peradventure. And this is it, English tea. Would you care to sit with me for a cup of English tea? Very twee, very me, any sunny morning. What a pleasure it would be, chatting so delightfully. Nanny bakes fairy cakes any sunny morning. Miles and miles of English garden stretching past the willow tree. Lines of hollyhocks and roses, listen most attentively. Do you know the game croquet? Peradventure we might play. Very gay, hip hooray, any sunny morning. Miles and miles of English garden stretching past the willow tree. Lines of hollyhocks and roses, listen most attentively. As a rule, the church bells chime when it's almost supper time. Nanny bakes fairy cakes on a Sunday morning.
Thank you.
As you can see, we've tried to make this a sort of different kind of thing, you know, just sort of mix up some of these things, all based on that different perspective idea. And look at this, will you? This is a mystery object. And I'm going to have great pleasure in revealing this. This is the original Elvis Presley bass. Exactly. This is the one. This is the bass. If you, those Elvis fans amongst you will recognize this little dashing white trim that is on all the early album covers. It was played by Bill Black, Elvis's bass player, and I always love to imagine that Bill would be here and Elvis would be standing right there. Yeah. Anyway, one of the stories I heard about this bass was that in the early days, Elvis, Scotty Moore, his guitar player, and Bill Black used to work as a trio, and they would be working locally in Tennessee, places like that. So you have to imagine beautiful starry night going along the interstate, Elvis driving, Scotty Moore and Bill Black, and this little baby strapped to the roof rack. Well, since my baby left me, I found a new place to dwell. It's down at the end of Lonely Street. It's a big hotel, baby. You've been so lonely, baby. You've been so lonely. You've been so lonely, you could die. Well, if you baby leave you, you've got a tale to tell. Just take a walk down Lonely Street to a big hotel. You'd be so lonely, baby. You'd be so lonely. You'd be so lonely, you could die.